fucking, you fucking bitch. This you bitch. Fuck you. Wasn't this like your last year's New Year's resolution? You know, I'm gonna make a game in 2024. You haven't taken any motherfucking steps, you fucking bitch. Jesus, I'll be back. Give me a second. Hello. If I don't shave for a little bit, I start to go wacky, you know. Before we get started, I wanted to say that currently I'm working on a project right now. I don't know if they want me to say. I actually forgot if they said that I could say or they couldn't. But, you know, I'm just going to say it anyways. And if I get in trouble, you know, what are they going to do? Fire me? They get fired. They already paid me. I've been working on a game under contract, and I'm announcing that game right now. And you can wishlist it on Steam right now. That game is World of Unlit. Woo! It's actually with my friend. His name is Maxine. He's been working on this game for the past 6 years.
Well, it's also not working. You can't go to America with that.
It's very big news. He's going to be releasing very, very soon next month. So if you want to support me, you can support him. That game is called World of Unlit. Go wishlist it right now. And if it's available to purchase, go buy it right now. Help me out. Help me out. Gotta pay my editor. Do you like money, editor? Probably yes. Probably they do like money. So you support that game, you support me. And I'll be making videos in the future more like this, because these videos are much easier to make than making the whole last fucking game in like a fucking week and then spending another week making a video about it. Holy shit. That shit's so fuck. You have been talking about making a game for such a long time. The one thing that has been stopping you is the question, what game engine should I use? There is going to be a definitive answer. I'm going to go over in detail, because I actually took notes for this. That's how much I care about your success in game development. I did the bare minimum, so you know. Hey, editor, cut that out. In terms of graphics and performance, Unreal Engine is the best engine if you want to go for AAA graphics. So if you're interested in learning how to do procedural generation and creating these big landscapes and AAA graphics, Unreal Engine is going to be the one that is more geared towards that. This is not to say that the other engines can't do that. You can still do procedural generation in Godot. You can still do procedural generation in Unity. One of the reasons why I used to recommend Unreal Engine in the past, if you wanted to make like AAA high fidelity graphical games, is because not only does Unreal have a lot of tools in order for you to make high fidelity games, but they also gave you access to the entire Quixel Megascan library. You might be wondering, I don't even know what engine to use. I don't know what that is. The Quixel Megascan library is a bunch of assets that Unreal used to give, or that as of currently recording is still giving out to use in your Unreal projects completely for free. And these are like high quality that they actually went out and then they took like a video recording of it in 2025. That is no longer going to be the case. So Unreal is not getting that benefit of the free Megascan library anymore, which is a little bit unfortunate. But hopefully, if you are watching this before 2025 and Fab has launched, they are actually giving out the entire Megascan library for free. They're making it free for every single platform and every single tool. This means that if you are using Unity, you can still use that Quixel Megascan library. Also, any tool that you want. So if you want to use it for Blender, guess what? You can use it for Blender too. Shit, like that's already there, you know? And you get to pay $0, nothing. You get to keep them and use them perpetually. That means that you get to keep it and use it forever. If you are watching this video before 2025, go check if Fab has launched. If it has launched, go download those assets right now, because it's not going to be available forever. I think they're still going to have some of them free. They're not going to have all of them for free. So for each individual asset, it's going to be 99 cents. For a procedural kit, it's going to be $5. And for an asset pack, it's going to be $25. Because Unreal Engine is sort of built to be like this everything sort of engine, you know? It has a bunch of built-in tools. Pretty much anything that you want to do, you can do in vanilla Unreal. You don't really have to go out and like try to build your own software or learn how to do something else. But because everything is in engine, Unreal is also the heaviest engine to use. It is not an easy engine to run for a computer. But I would say if you're worried about that, don't use Unreal. Move on to the other two, because Unreal is a really heavy engine. Sorry, didn't mean to bump into you. The other one is going to be Unity. In terms of graphics, is not bad, you know? It has a bunch of tools in order to make graphically appealing games. You know, we have HDRP. If you want to go for high definition, that's HDRP, is just high definition render pipeline. But that's actually going away in Unity 7, not 6, 7. But it is incredibly versatile. It has the support for the most amount of platforms, okay? So if you're looking to make mobile games, it is, I guarantee you, it's going to be easiest to do in Unity. I'm pretty sure the other engines also have support for console, but Unity 100% is going to be the easiest to be able to like actually export to these different platforms. Of course, multi-platform support is never going to be like just like a click and then you just send it out. Some cases for smaller games that could be true for like game jams, but you know, we're talking about a sizable project. That's not going to be true. You're always going to have to put in a little bit of work, but Unity does support that the most. Unreal and Godot both have support for VR. I want to learn VR in the future. Guess what? They both have it. Okay, Godot, this is what I wrote down, is optimized for 2D development. The biggest thing about Godot, especially if you're on a low-end computer, is that Godot is incredibly lightweight. If you're worried about like, I don't know if I can, if my computer is going to be able to run Unreal or even Unity, even Unity, like, damn, bro, what the fuck? Your PC, that shit, bro, shit. Then, you know, go with Godot. Easy answer for you right now. In terms of cost and licensing. Now, wait, before I get started, Unity had huge drama. Boop, boop, boop. I actually made a video about it with my previous editor. He spent a lot of time on that project. Only got like 2,000 views, whatever. I don't care. Here's the thing. Unity, in the past, bunch of stuff happened. This is the truth right now. They have literally reversed all of those changes. Yeah, Unity Pro is for over 200,000 in the last 12 months. You got to go over to Unity Pro, and then that's going to cost you $2,040. You do not have to go into Unity Enterprise until you reach revenue or funding greater than 25 million, and that is going to cost you, boop, it says right here, $3,000 a year, which if you're making over $25 million, like, that's, you know, that's like a drop in the bucket for you, unless you have like a lot of people employed. But at that point, you know, don't take advice from me, you know, you're on a new level. So Unity is probably the most aggressive with their pricing plan. And one of the biggest complaints that people have been talking about with Unity for the longest time has been the Made with Unity logo that is being taken away in Unity 6 for free. Usually you would have to pay the pro, which didn't make any sense before, because, like, you know, most people can't tell what engine you're working with. So if they see a bunch of small bad games with a Made with Unity logo, it creates this perception that Unity, and I'm pretty sure a lot of you might believe that too, that Unity can't make like really high fidelity games. But there's a lot of games, a lot of high fidelity games that have been made in Unity. If you're thinking about Unreal's pricing model is based off of percentage, and it's not a yearly pricing model that they have, that Unity has, and the percentage is 5%, which, you know, it may not sound like a lot, but it is like something significant, especially if you start to get in the upper ranges. But that 5% only kicks in when you reach over $1 million in revenue. And when you do get over that $1 million, you do not have to pay for the first million. You have to do 5% on any future revenue after you hit 1 million. And Godot is going to be the cheapest for you, which is, and by the way, all of these have been so far free to start out. You can learn the engine, and then if you are successful with it, then that is when you have to start paying back. I already know this. I don't know why I'm looking at my notes. Godot. Yep. Godot is going to be the cheapest option out of the three, with Godot being an open source game engine. What does that mean? Open source means that it's open to the public. You can just use it. You can use it, abuse it, do whatever you want with it under the MIT license. The MIT license just means that you can download the source code for Godot. You can make any sort of modifications for it. The only thing that you can't do, I believe, with the MIT license, you can't then resell the game engine. So if you create a different branch of Godot and you build upon it, that also has to have the MIT license with it. So it's like this sticky bug that you can't get rid of. You know, it's always going to be free no matter who downloads it, who modifies it. And if they're not doing that, then that's breaking the license, I think. So you might be wondering, like, wait a second, if Godot is using the MIT license, then that means that I can't make any money off of the games that I make. Like, I have to give off my games for free. That is no, sir, incorrect. The MIT license is only for the engine itself. It does not apply to any of the products that you make with the Godot engine. So if you make a game, or if you make a tool, or if you make something, then you could just give it out for free. or you can't give it out for free. You can sell it also, and you're not breaking the license. So that's great. So in terms of community support, the biggest reason why everybody used to use Unity in the past is because Unity has had the largest community support for their game engine. And I'm gonna be honest, that is still true today. There's so many resources out there for you to get. They have the Unity Asset Store if you wanna buy assets instead of making them your own. If you wanna learn how to make something or do something yourself, you can go onto YouTube and there's this huge archive of like basically anything that you wanna do in Unity, and it's just available for you for free. It is the biggest draw for Unity. This is not the case for Unreal. Unreal has the smallest community. You're not going to find a lot of resources for Unreal. I haven't dived too deep into the documentation, but I have heard off secondhand experiences that the Unreal documentation is lackluster. Godot was a much smaller engine. It had a really dedicated community behind it for a long time, but that community was small. It was not a big community for the Godot engine. Not a lot of people used it. When that Unity thing happened in the late 2023, that stopped being the case super, super quickly. A lot of people jumped from Unity over to Godot. People started making resources, and that was a year ago. So now you get the benefit in 2025 of working off of that support. People have made resources, people have made courses, people have made videos, people have made so many stuff for Godot. And now I would say it is still not close to Unity, but it is getting there. And the fact that you do have that big community now of people that are like advocating for Godot and their free and open source license, that's really good. Still, Unity is still bigger just because they've had like years and years and years of a huge community behind them. But the fact is, Godot is like starting to catch up. So in terms of beginner support, I think Unity was pretty intuitive for me to pick up. And I actually started learning Godot recently too. Godot is a really easy engine to get to. They use GDScript, which is like Python. I personally hate Python. It is like the worst written language ever, and GDScript is like Python, so it is like the worst programming language ever. But it is very readable, beginner friendly for a lot of people if you don't know how to code or if you've never touched code before. Unity works off of C#. C# is a little bit more difficult to use than GDScript, than Python, but this is my opinion. I think C# is easier to learn than something like JavaScript. JavaScript is like the beginner language that most people learn, jump into. Unity is probably not as easy to get into as Godot, but it's still pretty easy in my opinion. You can also use C# in Godot as well, but their naming... okay, listen, I have a lot of problems with the Godot API. Unity, in my opinion, is a nicer experience to program in. And Unreal, I really want to make a video about this, but Unreal offers C++, which is notoriously one of the most difficult languages to learn as a beginner. So if you're worried about that, you don't have to be worried because Unreal offers Blueprints. And Blueprints is a node-based programming language. So if you want to jump into Unreal, you still have the option of using Blueprints. And if you start to get really good at Blueprints, you can pretty much do anything you want to do in Unreal just straight in Blueprints. You never have to code. I want to make a video about that and why that's a mistake and why you shouldn't be thinking like that, you motherfucker. First, you're gonna fucking wait 5 fucking years to fucking figure out if you which engine to use, and then you're gonna not learn how to code, you stupid mother editor. Please remind me to make a video about that. Thank you. Thank you, editor. I made a bunch of points, and I want to say this. If you want to make a game, you can do it in whatever engine you pick, if it's one of these three. It is not super important which engine you pick. The only thing that I would say really, really matters is your computer hardware specs. If they are really, really bad, probably don't go with Unreal. Probably go with Godot, but it doesn't cost anything to try to use the engine. So if you're like, man, my computer is kind of bad, I don't know if I can run Unreal, guess what? It is free to download. You can grab it. You can see if your computer can run it. And if it doesn't, that's fine. You just move on to Godot, you know? In the future, make some money, you can switch to Unreal. But at that point, you would have already had knowledge to do anything that you want to do in Unreal in Godot. Is it going to be as easy to do these things in the engine as it would be in another engine that is more built for it? No. But the fact is, that you can make any game that you want in whichever engine you pick. Do not stress about this, okay? If you already started learning an engine and you already know that engine a little bit, stick with that engine. That is my recommendation. Peace out. Peace. Bye-bye. Wait, I said that there's going to be a definitive... Okay, listen. In the past, I would have said Unity because of the community support. That is changing. Godot has a much bigger community now. The benefits of it being open source are not something that can be argued against. If you make a successful game, you already have to pay 30% to Steam. You have to pay publishers if you're working with a publisher. You have to pay the people that helped you build your game. If you made it by yourself, you have to pay your rent, your food, your taxes. You have to pay for so much. If you make a successful game, you do not have to pay Godot anything. And the biggest thing that I was saying, like, hey, probably don't use Godot, was the fact that there's not a lot of resources out there. So if you get stuck, you're probably going to be stuck unless you really try really hard to, like, go into the documentation. That is not the case anymore. Right now, if you're brand new, my recommendation is Godot. Jump into Godot. You're not going to regret it. You can do anything you want to do. If you want to make multiplayer, you can do it in Godot. If you want to make a 3D AAA, you can make it in Godot. It's going to be a little bit different, might be a little bit more difficult, but you cannot deny the benefit of using Godot. Godot is my recommendation for 2025. Start using Godot in 2025. Start earlier, brother. Start earlier. Or sister. Anybody can make games. People of all types can make games. Everybody should be making games. If you want to make games, you can do that right now with Godot or Unreal or Unity or...